Ladies and gentlemen, the final three games for the championship of championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. Big Pat Patterson from St. Louis, leading by 91 pins. His opponent from Detroit, an up-and-coming star, Bobby Kwolek.
Everybody, and welcome once again. This is it, championship bowling from the beautiful Strike and Spare Lanes in Northbrook, Illinois. The first three games of the finals, if you were with us last week, has Pat Patterson out in front, a 7-30 series, Bobby Kwolek, 6-39. Last week, Patterson started with 10 in a row for 289. The margin is 91 pins, $10,000 to the winner, $5,000 to the runner-up. All competition sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress. Over $60,000 in prizes going through this week, and this is the final three games. The assignment for Kwolek, to get 91 pins on his opponent. And it'll be very interesting. All 300 games are worth $10,000 additional dollars. Are you ready, Northbrook? We're ready for the first game. All right, in one moment, here we'll be off.
Pat Patterson, starting the final three games. This is where he finished in his third game last week. Patterson reaches, throws, he's in on the nose, right through the middle of the big four. The margin is 91 pins. Can Bobby Kwolek catch him for $10,000? Patterson averaging 239 for his first nine games. Kwolek averaging 229. Big Patterson. He'll just go for the two.
Oh, he made three of the four. How about that?
Pat just made a motion. He says, I was going for two. He made three. Of course, he gave it a little left. Figures he can spare one pin out of the 91. So Bobby now has a chance to get 20 of those pins back in the very first frame if he can start with two. The big lift. He's got to hurry. He doesn't get there. And this is where we left Kwolek last week when he had all of his problems here on the right side. He had three misses last week for 639 and had all three misses here on the right side. Patterson had one miss on this side, the 2, 4, 5, and the 8. That's about what we have now. The four pin doesn't make much difference when you're trying to make this shot. Kwolek has the spare. Nice score. So the Detroit youngster has picked up 10 of the 91. Two games and nine frames to go. Quite an assignment for this fella. Born in Detroit in 1932, started as a pin boy 16 years later. Became quite a draftsman, an occupation he gave up to turn professional. In the second throws, he's there. So Kwolek again having no trouble on the left side. Patterson moving in on the right. Both these boys qualified for the finals, topping a field of 24 of the nation's outstanding stars. They both appeared twice, meeting different opponents. Total pins for the six games, it was Patterson 14-19, four pin, and Kwolek had 14-18. Those are six-game totals. Georgie Howard of Detroit was third with 1365. Then came Al Farragelli from Patterson, New Jersey, 1360. Carmen Salvino, 1359. Bill Benetta, 1347. At the four pin, Patterson covered. Billy Whalew, 1344. Johnny King, 1337. Lee Juglard was 1317. Andy Rakosnicka, 1313. And Tony Lindemann of Detroit, 1310. Those were the boys over 1,300. We have had seven 700 totals. Patterson has had two of them. 747 and 730. He's high again, the seven pin. Almost another wide open split. So Patterson, who went through the middle in the first frame, leaving the big four, left a four pin in the second frame. This time on the nose again, broke it up, nothing but the seven pin, and Bobby Kwolek with a chance to get some of those nine pins back in a hurry. So Bobby, on the strike, moves in on the right side. Let's see how he handles it. Now, he was short. This time, he's going to be right there. There's the double. And the youngster's off now. He has picked up 22 pins in three frames. He has a chance to go for 32. He's on the strike in the third. Patterson on the spare. Bobby rolled a 290 game on television in Detroit in 1960. And he rolled one on championship bowling here at Northbrook, Illinois, when he shot his big 763 series. Once more, and he has a triple. Well, Mr. Patterson's gonna have to pay attention, because Bobby Kwolek of Detroit is spare triple. Fill in the 30s, give him 50 in the second. He has a margin now of some 30 pins. We're in the fourth. Big Pat Patterson with the big turn. He'll be short. And here we see it again, the cluster of four. The 2-4-5. This was Patterson's only open frame in the first three games of this match. If you were with us last week, he missed it in the third game, then lined up about six in a row, and he finished with 234 for 730. The 2, the 4, the 5, and be careful, and he almost picked it. Boy, that's a big shot for Pat. He lost four pins and counts. So Kwolek actually picked up 14 pins on his strike in the fourth, which gave him the double against Patterson's spare. So Kwolek, with a couple of more strikes, can pick up more than 40 pins. Patterson in the fifth, moves left. He's out there again, and this time he has the same bucket, the 2-4-5-8, with a man in motion. That's the seven pin. He shot the half. He's got half of them left. He's lost five more pins and counts. And Mr. Patterson seems to be playing them just a little cozy. He doesn't want to get up on the nose. He started this match with a big four, and he's stayed away from that nose ever since. And here's another miss, three pins. And ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Kwolek, who will move in on the right, on three, with this strike, and one in the sixth, can take that 91 pins and actually pick up some 50 pins, even 60 pins. He still can have 110, 140 in the fifth. Hurry up there. He doesn't get there, and there's another bucket. Boy, that was a big one for Kwolek. He could have been knocking on the door with that strike. Kwolek could actually have been 140 in the fifth against Patterson's 66. That would have been 74 pins of the 91. He would have been trailing by only 14 pins. Now, that's hard to believe. He's got to spare. Oh, he just got there in time. So Bobby loses four in counts. At the end of five, Patterson open with 66. Kwolek is 96 in the fourth, and he's got a spare in the fifth. Now moving left. This is his favorite side. He throws automatic. He's there. One more. Well, every time Kwolek gets a strike on the right side, it's a turkey, actually, the way he's been bowling, because he seems to get practically all strikes on the left, which makes it quite interesting. These lanes are not alike. The boys have to work. Patterson now. He's been short here all the way. This time he's a little short. He may shake them up. And he leaves the five and the seven split. Kwolek has 50 pins here at the end of five frames. 50 pins. The margin has been cut to 41 pins. And Patterson throws it out too far. The margin is now less than 30. We go into the seventh. Patterson moves left. Big Pat, suddenly wondering just what is happening after averaging 239 for nine games. And last week with a 289 and a 234. Has had two splits, the first two splits of the match in 2 weeks. Reaches out, he's short again, and he has the two and the five and the seven. Kwolek is on a strike. And if Patterson misses this one, he'll have something like 83 in the seventh. Kwolek with two strikes can have 176 in the seventh. And this youngster's on his way, and Patterson's going to convert.
Nice shot, boy. He needs every one he can get. Great shot. And Pat is satisfied with that.
A nice shot. The 257. It's not easy. But Bobby's on the strike in the sixth. This match could suddenly become very tight. The big ball. He sets it. He's there. He's got it.
Bobby really working.
So he's hit the right side twice. He'll move left. He's up short, just outside the 12-foot line on two. Winds one up, and here she comes.
He's there, and there, ladies and gentlemen, is one more.
And the worm is turning as Mr. Pat Patterson from St. Louis, Missouri, finds his young opponent out in front by some 83 pins. The margin is less than 10. And it's all happened in seven frames. Patterson in the eighth, reaching out. He gets there, short, breaks up the 5-7, leaves nothing but the 5-pin. And Bobby Kwolek now, who is on the strike in the eighth against Patterson's cover here of this easy spare, can get out of this game taking the lead, which is almost unbelievable, beating a man who has been averaging 239 by over 90 pins in one game. Don't go away. History in the making on Championship Bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. Fred Wolf, along with our statistician, Charlie Crovetti. No one can believe what they're seeing. Kwolek is still potential 266. The best Patterson can get if he goes all the way is 173. In the ninth, Patterson gets this one. There,
here we are.
With his first strike, a chance for 173. Kwolek can go all the way for 266. 266. Now, if both men go all the way, Kwolek will have the lead. This is a big frame for him. The 90 sets it there. He's got it. He's got it. And that's number four. The Detroit youngster coming from nowhere with a big one here. 266. Don't get nervous, Charlie. Just relax. Bobby moves left, going out on his favorite side. He'll be going out here, incidentally. This game and the final game, this is the side he likes, and it may make a difference. Be careful. Too high. Four pin stops him. Just a bit too tight. So Patterson now, with a big 10th frame, can get a few pins back. If Pat doesn't double, this thing has got to be very close. Bobby Kwolek, the cover here for 245. There it is. The full count for Bobby Kwolek will give him 245. Patterson will need a strike in the 10th. To keep the lead. If Patterson does not get his strike and fills for 153, Bobby Kwolek will be leading by one pin. Patterson needs this strike to get the lead back. Actually, he trails. A spare is not enough. With two games to go, the margin could be one pin. It's up to Patterson. And here he comes. He's going to be there. He's got the big double. So it's Patterson by nine. One more will make the margin 19. Patterson was trailing going into the 10th frame. Had a lead of 91 pins, three games to hang on to it, and he gave it all back in nine frames. Patterson in the 10th. He's been a great clutcher the last three frames, four frames. The ninth and tenth, he's been tough. Here it comes.
It's there. There's another big one.
Oh, you can't deny experience, and this fella has got it. He knows exactly what he's doing, 173, and he now has 19 pins to work on, roughly. Kwolek off with 245, and here's Patterson finishing with four in a row for 173. He has lost 72 pins of his margin with the full count. It's there, it's in, and he doesn't mind that. The four pin, it was a good spot. And we got a real good one going here, ladies and gentlemen. It's the final match, championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. $10,000 to the winner, $5,000 to the runner-up. Fred Wolf, now your host. We'll be right back for game number two. Pay attention.
Here are the scores at the end of the first game in our final three games. Bobby Kwolek trailing by 91 pins, opening with 245 against Pat Patterson's 172. Two games to go. The margin, 18 pins. Pat Patterson out in front. Did you enjoy this first game, ladies and gentlemen? I guess everybody enjoyed it but Pat Patterson. Probably that wasn't the right thing to say. It should be a close one, so let's hang on in the next two games. Let's give them both a little encouragement now. Come on, both. All right, here we go.
Second game. The margin only 18 pins. That's one ball, one way or the other. A bad break for Patterson, a double for Kwolek is the difference. Kwolek actually was leading by one pin in the ninth frame.
And if he'd have carried one in the tenth, he would have kept Mr. Patterson busy.
Patterson, the great clutcher that he is, got the strike in the ninth. He had a very bad game coming up. He went all the way, leaving the four pin on his final ball for 172 to take the lead again by 18 pins. He picked up 20 pins in the 10th. Throws it out, and here she comes. And there she is. So we're off again with strikes in the first frame. So Patterson, who had just about everything happen to him that could happen, got out pretty good, still to maintain the lead. And after all, one pin is enough to win. He has 18 of them. Patterson now moving left. Chance to put the youngster on the spot. If he gets his double, Kwolek's going to have to get his. Be careful. He is on the nose, and he leaves the four and the seven. Well, there's a rolling pin, and the AMF indicator indicates 4-7. Those two pins put right back off spot. That's an ABC requirement. As Patterson shoots at the 4-7 and covers the spare. So it'll be Bobby Kwolek stepping up on the right, where he really works. This is his big problem, to get the ball in the pocket on lane 48. Bruce Pluckham, the public relations director of the American Bowling Congress, with us again this week, as is Joe Smolin, also the ABC staff. And Bobby reaches, throws, hurry, 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 hurry. There's a double. So the margin now cut down to just eight pins. We're in the third frame, and Bobby Kwolek can take the lead here with a strike in the third because Patterson is on the spare. What an assignment the youngster had, trailing by 91 pins against one of the great bowlers in this great sport, Pat Patterson. Patterson having his troubles. Kwolek going with 245. We're in the third. He's got to dig one. He's got it. And Bobby Kwolek now, ladies and gentlemen, is officially out in front through the first three frames of game number two. Pat can't do too much about it right now, but a strike here and another one in the fourth would force Kwolek to get his first one. Patrick Patterson just turns around. He knows where that one is. On the nose, and he broke it up to 3-6-10. He loses three pins and counts. Pat Patterson started bowling when he was only 12 years old. Many years ago, Pat's father averaged 190. He has rolled 31 perfect scores, 10 of them sanctioned. Three. 3, 6, 10, cover, cover. He doesn't get there. And ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Kwolek from Detroit, who sits on 3, Patterson opens in the third. A chance to really get out in front, and a big upset could be in the making. But don't count Mr. Patterson out. Once he gets the line, this guy may strike the rest of the series. And he can do it. He's shown it week after week. Patterson reaches, throws, and he is too high. Six spin, broke it up. Pat Patterson, who was averaging 239 per game for his first 9 games, opens with 172. He had a lead of 91 pins. Kwolek had 245, cutting the margin to 18. Just missed the 3-6-10. This time he covers the 6. And the Detroit youngster now moves in on the right side. He's out in front. He is on a strike. He's on 3 of them, as a matter of fact. We fill in the 30s. It's 30-double. Patterson with a spare in the fourth, so Kwolek has a chance to pick up 20 more pins with 2 strikes. One here, one in the fifth. This is his tough side. He'd like this one. He sets it right there. He leaves the 5 pin. Now, Bobby was very deep with that one. So Patterson, very much in here, not losing too much ground. Kwolek had the great opportunity. And that may be the difference. We're just halfway, a game and a half to go. Bobby, 33 pins out in front of this game. He's got a margin now of 15 pins at the end of 4. That strike would have made it 25, a chance to move left to make it 35. Bobby Kwolek out in front, 15 pins. We're in the 5th, second game. Throws, he is high, but he got away with one. Oh, there's a good break. A great break for the youngster. It'll be interesting to see what he can do with it. He takes his seat, each man bowling 2 complete frames. This is the final 3 games on championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. $10,000 to the winner, $5,000 to the runner-up. And Pat Patterson is in that pocket, leaving the 4 pin. The wobble and the wiggle, and the AMF pin spotter comes down, picks that pin up, puts it right back off spot, and returns the wiggle. Or is it a wobble? There's the spare. So at the end of 5, halfway in game number 2, Patterson is 65 spare. Bobby Kwolek is 99, and he's on a big strike. Patterson now moving to the left, looking for the strike. Get that string going. There he is, 9 pin this time, and things are getting a little tight for Pat Patterson. He can't get the kick. Left to 4, and now the 9. Mort Luby Jr., publisher of the National Bowlers Journal, with us again this week. Jimmy Kearns, public relations man for the World's Invitational Match Game Championships, held here in Chicago every year. And Pat Patterson has been a finalist in that event. And this youngster, of course, with a great career out in front of him, is a fellow you're going to hear more about. Already has won an ABC title. Remember the team that set the all-time high in St. Louis in 1959. Look out. Right in the middle. The 3 and the 6. And Kwolek showing some signs of getting just a little bit concerned about the situation. And this could make the difference in the match. This is a big thing for this youngster. Patterson's been through it many times. So he's missed the right side now twice in this game. 3, the 6, he's got the score. Bobby was a finalist 5 times in 1961 on a summer tour of the Professional Bowlers Association. His best finish was a 4th. In the National All-Star, the big 100-game event, he is qualified for the finalists once. That happened in 1956. His easy side, he's right back. Well, it's the same story. If Mr. Kwolek can find his line again on the right, Mr. Patterson will have his hands full. So we go into the seventh frame. Kwolek is 136. He has his strike in the seventh as Patterson tries for his strike in the seventh on a spare. Little tight seven pin. Patterson unable to match Kwolek in the seventh. Bobby on the strike has a lead of 14 pins and a chance to make it 24 if he can get his double. Claude Lewis Patterson. One of the nicest guys you'd want to meet. The seven pin he has. There's two boys, Gary and Michael, sitting in the audience again this week, rooting for Dad to get that $10,000 and bring it back to St. Louis. Patterson now moves to the left side. Patterson averaging 232 for his first 10 games, Kwolek 230. But of course now that Mr. Kwolek has the 15-pin advantage, their averages are identical. There it is. That's the ball. Patterson now with a strike in the eighth as he begins to make that big move. This fellow closes strong, game after game. That first game, he finished with three, one in the ninth and two in the tenth, to get the lead back. And now Bobby Kwolek trying to match Patterson's strike in the eighth. He is on one. This will give him 10 more pins. Can he get it up there? Here it comes. It's there. He's got the big double and the good line back again on the right. He moves left, his favorite side. So we go into the ninth, both boys on strikes. The margin is some 25 pins. Kwolek has them, a game and two frames to go. $10,000 to the winner, $5,000 to the runner-up. This is championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. Fred Wolf, the crowd sensing a big upset. Can the youngster hang on? We're in the ninth. He throws it up, it's out, here it comes, it's there, thin, not enough of the pocket. Then he's got himself a tough leave and he's missed his favorite side. The pressure beginning to mount. It showed up there as Kwolek didn't want to be too high, but here's the side that he has had no trouble on. So now it's whether or not he can stand the strain of realizing that here he is on the threshold of really kicking off his career with a big win worth $10,000. The two, and he picked it, he picked it. And Kwolek now beginning to feel the weight. As Patterson moves in on the right, ready for the kill. He's on the strike. Here's the big one. Patterson can get the lead back with a couple of strikes. We're in the ninth frame, the big frame, to get the big strike. Kwolek couldn't do it. He was open. Patterson winds one up and sets it right there. Look here, the big double. The big double, and Pat wasn't too sure what happened. He thought he was going to be high, and that ball just sat there all the way. So he has the double now as he begins to close in. This will give him 180 some in the ninth. He trailed by 14, and he threw it out the window and leaves the eight pin. Boy, he got a lot of them. So Pat, unable to take advantage of that double in the tenth, the cover here will give him 192, and Kwolek can redeem himself with a double in the tenth and have some pins to work on to go into the third and final game. There's the cover by Patterson. Well, this match will be within a pin or two with one game to go. It'll be the 12th game for both of these fellas. They each bowled two matches in the qualifying rounds. Patterson winning one, defeating Johnny King. Then he lost to Georgie Howard. Kwolek has won both of his matches. He defeated the great Dick Weber and Hank Lauman. On the nose, he gets eight of them. So Pat Patterson with 190. 190. Pat had a lead of 18 pins going into this game. So Kwolek, by filling in the 10th and the full count, will have 214. That would be 24 pins. If Bobby just fills the frame, he'll have a lead of possibly five or six. There's the first strike. Now the double is important. It gives him 10 additional pins to carry into the big final game. Boy, that ninth frame, he's going to be able to look back at that frame if he loses this match. On his favorite side, didn't get it up, the 258, and he picked it. So Kwolek would like this one for 224. Would give him a lead of 16 pins. Throws it out, and here it comes. Thin, he carries! Carries! Remember that one? Oh, remember that one? He had the 5-10. He made a double out of it. Now the count for 224. The full count. Kwolek will win this game by 34 pins. He won the first game by 73 pins. Patterson had a lead of 91. It'll be now Kwolek going into the final game with a lead of 16 pins with the count. He reaches out, sets it a little tight, gets eight of them, so the margin now should be around 12 pins. We'll check it out and really ride with the final game. Don't go away. It's $10,000 to the winner, $5,000 to the runner-up, including, of course, the beautiful championship trophy. The margin is 14 pins. Kwolek has them. We'll be back for the third and final. Pay attention to this. It's from your hosts.
Here are the totals, ladies and gentlemen. We have one game to go. And boy, this is going to be a real battle. Pat Patterson, 190. Bobby Kwolek makes it two straight, 222. The totals, 362 for Patterson, 467 for Bobby Kwolek. He has picked up 105 pins, trailing by 91. Kwolek leading now by 14 pins. And we have one game to go. The difference, $5,000. The winner, $10,000. The runner-up, $5,000. You're all ready, Northbrook? Let's hold on here now. Here we go.
Pat Patterson, starting off the third and final game, he trails by 14 pins. He got a little advice from his youngster over there, little Mike, the little guy. He said, Daddy, why don't you use another ball?
There he goes.
And Pat just told the youngster, he said, it isn't the ball, son, it's your daddy. Well, after shooting 730, this doesn't look like the same Patterson we were looking at last week. But we've got one game to go. A great clutcher. We'll see what he can do. And the youngster now from Detroit, Bobby Kwolek, trying to hold on to 14 pins. He's going to be there. He's got his first strike. Well, Bobby has one assignment. He has to do what Patterson does. He can make probably one mistake. Or he might be able to afford one tough break. If he can do everything else that Patterson does, he can possibly pull this one out with those four pins he's got. He can stand to lose 10. But here, with strikes, of course, one strike, one open frame, the difference can go to as much as 23 to 24 pins. His favorite side, can he get the double? Can he get the double? He's too high. And Patterson now in the driver's seat. He's got the strike. Boy, Bobby slowed that one down. That ball must be getting heavy. Bob Kwolek, who attended McKinsey High School in Detroit and Wayne University, a fine draftsman, now drawing that line in the 1-3 pocket as a professional bowler. He's got the spare. So Pat Patterson now on the right side. Kwolek, at least, will be going out on his favorite side. Now that may be the big difference. Big Pat Patterson on a strike. Big lift, big turn, dig it there, boy. He doesn't get there, and he has the 258, and Pat is just a little bit unhappy with that one, so Kwolek still has got to come out of this frame with at least the 14 pins that he has enjoyed to carry into the third game with eight frames to go. And Pat has a pretty tough shot. We've been looking at this one for 26 weeks. The 2-4-5-8, the bucket, the 2-5, and Pat's going to cover beautifully with the ball, all three pins. Say, I'll tell you something, gentlemen. I wonder, is there a bowling league where you work? I bet you don't even know. Did you ever check? You know, many companies and plants have teams and leagues. You can have yourself a lot of fun. Check, see if there isn't a bowling league where you work. Get in the league. Have your fun. Get to know the fellas you work with so much better. We're in the third. Patterson throws up, and he's got another strike to work on. So Bobby Kwolek now moving in on the right side. On the side that, of course, keeps both men busy. Bernie Cross, our technical advisor. Art Pickens, our co-producer, all over there about as nervous as a couple of bugs in a rug. Sid Goltz, our producer-director. Look out, Bobby, in the middle, the 3-6-10. And he's lost three pins in counts right there. He was too high. And Pat Patterson now, with a double, can get within one pin of Kwolek. Assuming that the Detroit youngster will cover this spare, the three, the six, the ten, cross lane, it's not easy. He's got it. He's got it. Oh, had to wait a minute for that one. So at the end of three, Patterson out in front by three pins. Bobby moves left. That's enough room. Ten pin stops him. So Kwolek throwing that one a little soft. And Pat Patterson sitting back here just waiting. Waiting to make the kill. Can he do it? Cross lane. Ten pin. Bobby has the spare. Handled very nicely. So Kwolek, who started with a strike, three straight spares, will watch Pat Patterson move in here on the right side, bowl two complete frames, two strikes by Patterson, and he'll have the lead back. This strike will put him within three pins of his opponent. And he's going to be too high. In the middle, the 310, life for Kwolek. So Pat has been unable to get the double twice. He's had two chances, missed both times on the right. And boy, this lane 48 has suddenly become a monster. Both boys very concerned, fighting a condition that means you've got to keep a tight line and stay inside. The three and the 10 and a great conversion, and that one could be worth $5,000. That could have been the biggest 310 that Patterson ever made. Remember that. An opener there, and Kwolek would have had over 20 pins to work on. We're approaching the fifth frame of the third and final game. Patterson plants that right foot where he wants it. He's about 13 feet back. Four big steps, the big follow through, the lift, he's there, tight, four pin. And every frame that Patterson does not get the strike, it means another frame that Kwolek does not have to strike. If he can fill the frames, he can nurse along the 14 pins that he started with. He trails in this game by four. The margin is actually 10, an even 10 pins. Now, when it's an even 10, it means that a double by Patterson would put him even. And then the count is going to become very important. Whichever man is short on count, on any one ball, this thing may go to one pin. Fifth frame. Bobby Kwolek reaches out, and he's got this. He's right there. Boy, that's the line. Now he hits that line every once in a while, and Patterson was watching it very closely. Pat's been unable to get there, so we're at the end of five. Patterson is 79 spare. Kwolek is 76 with a big strike. We're into the final five frames. Bobby Kwolek still leading by 11 pins. He is on a big strike. Now his margin can go to 21. Can he get this big one? He throws it out. Here it comes. Nothing on it. The ball getting heavy. Kwolek has missed that lane now twice. And he's got the bucket up there. Oh, he dropped that one. Pressure's beginning to mount. And he's got a tough one to shoot at. The two, the four, the five, and the eight. The bucket. And be careful. Oh, man, look at that five pin. It's still on the pin deck. Bobby can take a breath. He didn't lose any pins and counts. He was on a strike. So the margin is still 11 pins as Pat Patterson moves in on the right side in the sixth frame. One double by Patterson. Right now, this thing can be even to the pin. Here's the first one, right there. Look at that one. Ho, ho. Well, Patrick, let's see what you can do with that one. Boy, he was very high. The 4-6 looked at him. The 4 went down in a hurry. But the 6 was there. It fell this way. The margin is still 11 pins. Kwolek has them. We're in the seventh frame of the final game for the championship. of championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois, Fred Wolf right here as Patterson throws it in and leaves the five pin, and Kwolek still has the 11 pins. Patterson, for the third time, missed his double. And this fella, throughout his entire nine games prior to this match, did not have many single strikes. He made most of them good. At the five pin, he covered. So now, the youngster from Detroit, it's all up to him. He's got it in his hands. Let's see what he can do with it. He's in the seventh. A strike here and a double in the eighth will give him some 25 pins with two frames to go. Can he do it? Well, he's got one. Oh, look at that eight pin. Remember that one. Don't you dare forget it. Kwolek finally got in good. Well, he's been in here once or twice like that in the last two games. It's been very tough for him on this side, just as tough for Patterson, too. And that eight pin jumped up there. You wonder where it came from. So he can't get the double. The margin now is 10 pins. 10 pins difference. The cover. We go into the eighth frame. Three frames remaining, ladies and gentlemen. Three frames. These boys winding up their 12th game, both averaging around 230. It's been six games total pins. Patterson won the first three games last week by 91 pins. Kwolek got 73 of them back in the first game, 32 more in the second game to take it. A 14-pin lead, and here we are in the eighth. The margin is now 10 pins. Up and in, a 7-pin count. The margin now down to 7 pins. Now, we've mentioned that counts are probably going to decide this thing the way it looks. Now, Bobby hasn't been in that pocket on the left side this game at all. He's had two strikes, one in the first and one in the fifth, both on his tough side, and he just left a solid eight. The two, the four, the five, going away. Boy, they're getting tougher every time. Now, Pat Patterson, by virtue of the seven-pin count of Kwolek, has the margin down to 7 pins. It was 10. He picked up 3. So Patterson, in the eighth, with a strike here and a strike in the ninth, can take the lead. The first one looks good. Well, the fourth pin was up there. And here, ladies and gentlemen, here we go again as we go into the final two frames of another game where Pat Patterson always seems to shine. In the first game, he had a bad one going. He got a strike in the ninth and went all the way. Second game, he caught a double in the eighth and ninth. Now he's got the biggest strike of the entire tournament right in his hands in the eighth. He trails by 7. This will give him the lead. He's got it. So Pat Patterson, ladies and gentlemen, has taken the lead back. So he leads by 3. So Kwolek will bowl out first. Patterson will know exactly what he needs. So Bobby's got to make it tough. Let's see what he can do. He's back there. He carries. And now, Bobby Kwolek, who prefers the left side and has been unable to get a strike here in this entire game, will go left. Again, if he goes all the way, he'll have 212, and he can force Patterson to get another strike. Patterson leads by 3. Story here, Patterson has lost one pin in counts through 9 frames. Kwolek has lost 8. He needs this strike. He throws it there, and he got it. Well, now, you go to the will have an assignment. It all depends on what the youngster does with this one. 212. Kwolek had a lead of 14 pins going in. Right now, he needs 1. Bobby throws, reaches, sets. He's in. He carries. And boy, that's the biggest ball he ever threw in his life. Bobby Kwolek coming through in the 9th and 10th, and he has put Pat Patterson, the veteran from St. Louis, right on the spot. Bobby's so excited, he's just mumbling to himself out there. He can't believe what he's seen. He just doesn't believe that he got up to the foul line. Bobby Kwolek now. The count won't make too much difference. Yes, it will, because Patterson We'll need two strikes and a big count if he gets them all.
He's got them all. Yes, sir. Boy, there could be three of the biggest strikes this young man ever threw in his life. And Pat Patterson, it's 212.
Kwolek was leading by 14. That's 226. It's very simple. Patterson needs 227 to win by one pin. To get 227, he needs two strikes and eight pins. Here's the first one.
Doesn't get there. The winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Bobby Kwolek from Detroit in one of the biggest upsets in the history of championship bowling here from Northbrook, Illinois.
What a great finish. For this youngster who lost the first three games last week by 91 pins, he will win all three games this week, not only picking up the 91, but coming home the victor by some 19 pins, the cover by Patterson. And the full count will give Pat 207. He loses this game by five pins with the full count. It'll be Bobby Kwolek of Detroit by 19 pins. There it is.
Oh, that's where he wanted that first one. So Pat Patterson, one ball away. Just one ball away in the final game. It's Kwolek 212. Patterson 207.
We'll have a word or two with these two fellas. And then, of course, the presentations. It's the final game, the final frame of championship bowling from Northbrook, Illinois. Now stay right here because our host has a message for you.
Well, let's check them over, take a good look at them. For Pat Patterson, 172, 190, and 207, a total of 569. 730 last week, the total for the six games, 1299. For Bobby Kwolek, 639 last week, he trailed by 91 pins. 245, 222, 212, the total 679, the six game total 1318. The winner, Bobby Kwolek, the runner-up, Pat Patterson. Pat, I know you were well aware of the fact you needed two strikes and eight pins.
Yes, I was.
And when he got his second strike in the 10th, of course, it made it that difficult. And when you got your second strike in the 10th, it was obvious to us that you realized you threw the ball, didn't you? You weren't sure that you threw it, really?
I don't know. It just came out of my hand.
Just came out of your hand, and you got the big strike. Well, you put Pat on the spot. We sort of felt that Pat was going to get the two strikes, Bob. You know, a few weeks ago, he needed three strikes here to beat you by one pin. He got them, and after he made the spare, he threw the next one right in there. But you, both you boys were fighting this left side. It made it quite a contest. Pat?
I was fighting both of them.
You were fighting both of them. Well, after what we had a chance to see last week, it's hard to believe what happened this week. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen, for the very important presentations. Well, we're going to call back our two finalists once more, and I'm sure this will be very pleasing to them because we have our executive producer, Mr. Walter Schwimmer, to make the presentations. Mr. Schwimmer, please. Let's give him a nice hand. Big ball. We have a very pleasant task here. A couple of boys that have done a great job.
First, I'd like to congratulate you, Fred, for a very fine job. And also thank the sponsors. God bless them. I hope they'll be back next year.
Thank you.
If Pat Patterson steps up, it's my very happy privilege, Pat, to give you first a check. I want you to know that not so long ago, I would make in 1 year what you've made in a one afternoon's performance, $5,000. Congratulations, and here
Thank
is
you
your
very, much.
Very fine cup. Bob Kwolek. Congratulations, Bob. There's almost 30 million bowlers in the United States of America. This is America's number one participation sport. And right now, Bob, you're the champion of them all, the number one bowler in the entire world. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
A check for $10,000 and this wonderful big cup.
Thank
Congratulations.
You
See you again next year.
Thank you very much.
You have a word, Robert?
Yes, I'd just like to take this opportunity.
Come on over here, it's a little
Whoa! To say I'm very, very happy, and I feel very, very fortunate
And I would just like to say thank you all in Northbrook. You've been wonderful to me.
Thank you, Bobby. Well, that about winds up another one. Championship Bowling here from Northbrook, Illinois, at the beautiful Strike and Spare Lanes. We'll see you again on Championship Bowling. This is Fred Wolf reminding you once again that you don't have to play a sport good to be a good sport. Goodbye. Matching shirts and slacks used on Championship Bowling by King Louie. Championship Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress, and we wish to thank AMF for their cooperation in helping us to produce Championship Bowling.